two or three of my little calls just to know what I'm doing. Well, it ain't your business what I'm doing. It's not your business what I'm doing. And what I want you to know, I will tell you. But they gonna do their thing, and I'm gonna do my thing, and I'm gonna be fine. But that's how folks do you. You turn on the TV, if you stay home on Sunday morning sometime on Channel 36, you don't see nothing else on there. This city right here got a long way to go for us concerning racism.
Yeah, we have.
I'm sorry, I got to be real.
Yeah.
We got a long ways to go because, see, I'm not going to let them treat me any kind of way.
That's right.
I'm not going to do it. And they will do it if you let them. And they will define you if you let them. But just because I'm not saying nothing, they're coming back and saying, oh, little old me. Somebody told me, Representative Cunningham, now you know you're going to have to look this way when you interview because you know you kind of hard. You better be looking soft. Look at this little woman. And she was an elected official. She said, you better get, she said, you better work on it. She said, because they not going to be able to take that. And I'm saying to myself, all these years, we done took this crap.
Yes, come on.
Time out. It ain't time up, it's time out. It's time out. And so what I want to say to you, don't let folk define you.
That's right.
You walk in your destiny.
Yes.
You don't get for one life.
That's right. That's right.
You gonna let everybody else live it for you?
Right.
That's all you get. You ain't getting but one. If you can tell me where I can get another, let me know now. Because I want to stand up. If you can tell me, I need a whole lot more than that. I don't want to get rid of you now. But see, that's not God, is it?
Yes.
I always say I'm in the spiritual realm.
Amen.
I'm not religious. I'm in the spiritual realm.
Amen.
I'm in the spiritual realm.
Amen.
I know folk there.
Yeah.
That's why there ain't a whole lot of folk around me that can meet you on that mountain.
That's right.
That's why everybody can't go.
That's right.
That's why everybody can't go. Because they can't get up there.
No.
Yeah.
And it's a special space.
That's right. It's very special.
Wayne Dyer.
I love him.
I love him.
God rest his soul, yes.
But I had every book he wrote. He's a white man.
Uh-huh.
But I had every book he wrote. And sometimes, you know, you get a burning desire. You get this burning desire. And most of the time, God has given it to you. And all of a sudden, you got to lose your man about this thing that you want to do. And everybody else telling you, you can't
don't do it.
Yeah, they telling you and they talking about you behind your back.
Right.
But then if you get over young, they gonna say, well, can you loan me something?
Right.
But they ain't never made a donation or a contribution. I'm giving it right now. Folks calling me. Can you call me back? And my brain go. You don't know where you go sleep.
Uh-huh.
And so I said, I ain't gonna be for y'all. I didn't know how it was gonna happen then.
Right.
You know, I had too much to do with it.
Mm-hmm.
But it's interesting. Cause some people say, well, when you married her, she much younger than you. You know, talking about husbands. But my husband loved me.
Amen.
And I loved him enough to quit my job. Stay at his bedside until he got this word.
Mm-hmm.
Folk don't know what you've been through.
Yes.
They can't tell your story because they ain't lived your story.
Yes.
And things don't impact them until it's personal.
Yes.
Until it touches your personal life. It just doesn't happen. So I can't ask you to empathize with me if you ain't been what I've been.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
because you're not qualified to do it. But you can understand and sympathize. Can't empathize, because the empathize is taking the shoes off and walking.
That's right.
And putting them on and walking them in her space, in his space. But I can sympathize with you. But it's a sad day, though. It's a sad day in the city when you going down North Tran, and seven year old woman lose her life. Because she drove through a shootout.
Yes.
Two more shot last night. And it's gonna be some money. We're not ready yet. We're not sick and tired.
No.
And I ain't talking about riding in the street. I'm talking about becoming politically engaged to be the change you want to see. It's people that change policies, it's not me.
That's right.
It's people that move policy to the top of the list. We're struggling in mental health trauma. Racism created a lot of trauma that we have yet to be able to even engage on and talk to each other about. Ambassador Rasool, South Africa, was the ambassador for Barack Obama. I had the pleasure to meet him a couple months ago. He came to Charlotte. He said, 3 days, he was to engage people from all different walks of life. And they were to come into this room for 3 days and stay for 3 days, and to come out with one goal, one issue that would change the lives of the people in the apartheid. They came out. The issue was racism. The issue was racism. He stated, until you've had the experience or you've had the struggle, you cannot be. Until we, as a community, as a nation, as a country, attack the issue of racism, we cannot get to healing and reconciliation.
Mm-hmm.
And guess what? We ain't there.
Nope.
We're not there. We can't even have one talk to each other. Am I my sister's keeper? Am I my brother's keeper? I was telling somebody a while ago, I said, I'm not afraid of money. But you know what I raised more money off of? Men. That's why I raised my money from. Few women give me some money. People see you moving and they think you're a shape. They get jealous. They get jealous.
That's right.
They start talking to you. They show me. I ain't paying her nothing. She thinks she all gets paid. You know?
That's right.
But am I my sister's keeper?
Yeah.
I don't care what you say. I'm going right up there and I'm fighting for my sister's issue.
Yes.
I'm going to do it anyway.
Yeah.
Do it anyway.
That's right.
It don't matter what nobody say about you.
That's right.
Talk is cheap. It ain't putting no dollars in your pocket.
Right.
That's why I tell folks, call me on the phone, can you write me a check?
Right.
No, I'm serious. Don't take up my time on an issue if you can't write me a check. I was on the phone the other night, I'm going to stop talking because I can't talk to no politician to talk. But I don't consider myself a politician, I consider myself a servant. I was on the phone the other day and I was raising some money because I'm getting my stuff stacked up now for the next year. And the doctor said to me, said, you sound mighty excited. And he's African doctor. I said, well, I need to sound excited. I'm trying to raise money. I'm not what I'm supposed to sound like. You know, you can't get that coming. You all named that.
That's right.
Well, you give it 25 hours. No, I would say, what level would you like to come? He said, what's the number? I said, 550 and 1,000. Where you want to be? You don't want to be on the bottom. I'm serious. He said, well, I'll do 750. I said, thank you very much. I said, send me the address so I can send you an invitation. I said, you can text it because this is my private. I was scared to do it. But after a while, I got pretty comfortable because I said, you know, I need raises money. But I'm not afraid of money. But I used to be.
Right.
You know, I don't feel broke. I don't even carry no cash. And I don't feel broke. But I had some cards, but shoot, I was in Goodwill yesterday. Real serious, you know, just to have a few classic pieces. But I'm not going crazy now. I'm keep some of my money. But you know, they said women are the biggest consumers.
That's right.
Yes.
And we are, we consume and we give so much of ourselves. And I've learned, I'm 57. 57 years old, I got another great grandson. I love him to death. And they be looking, talking about, you sure it's a young great grandmother. I said, well, I gave it all up early. you know, because if I had, I wouldn't be able to have the life I have now.
Yeah, yeah.
Everything has a purpose.
That's right.
Time and a season.
Amen.
And I'm just beginning to walk in that. I'm just beginning to walk in that. Because for the first time, I can say what I want to do.
Yes.
I can go where I want to go. And I don't have to answer the phone. I don't want to answer the phone.
Right.
I don't have no husband. And guess what? I don't want another. God gave me two. He gave me two. I'm going to be 65 in another 5 years. I'm fine. I have a companion. That's all I need.
Okay.
Because I come and go as I please. So when that's good, it works for me. But you know, you need companion for quality of life.
Yes, right.
I ain't telling nobody about to get married. I'm just not gonna lose my benefits.
Your stability.
Well, that's insurance.